upon a time, there was a brave boy called Jack, who lived with his mother in a little wayside village. Now, Jack was a very wasteful boy and spent all the money they had. Oh, you heedless, wasteful boy. All I have is gone. The only thing to do now is to sell my poor cow. Now, Jack was really very sorry and got up next morning early to sell the cow. As he walked along, he met a butcher.
Hello, my lad. Where are you going with that thin old cow?
She's neither thin nor old, and I'm going to sell her.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you this bag of beautiful beans for her,
seeing you're such a smart and clever young fella. Well, Jack was very flattered at being called smart and clever. He took the beans, and the butcher, well, he went off with the cow laughing. When Jack got home, his mother was very angry at his silliness. Oh, you careless, good-for-nothing boy. What have you done? Fancy selling the cow for a few paltry beans. He was so angry, she threw them out of the window. Next morning, Jack awoke and looked out, and where his mother had sown the beans, there was a great, thick beanstalk growing right up into the clouds. Jack made up his mind he would climb to the top. When he reached the clouds, he found himself in a strange country, and started off to walk until he got tired. So he sat down, and presently, he heard the most beautiful music. Then he saw a fairy, who said, "How did you come here?" Jack told her all about the beans and the cow, and she said, "I know all about that, for I caused you to act as you did. A wicked giant who lives in this land ruined and killed your father and took all his possessions. If you are brave and true, I will help you to regain your fortune." The fairy vanished, and Jack went in search of the giant's castle. He rang the bell. The woman who came to the door looked very frightened. "Go away at once. My husband is a wicked and cruel giant, and if he catches you, he will eat you up. But I'm tired and hungry. Please let me in." Well, she consented. She led him through a hall into the kitchen, where everything was warm and comfortable. She gave Jack a good supper, and just as he had finished it, he heard a noise like thunder. That's the giant. He's blowing his nose. Then Jack heard ramp. Ramp, ramp, ramp. Then there was a knock on the door. Made the house shake, and all the plates rattled.
Bring me my half.
The
red tip was placed on the table, it began to play the most beautiful music. The giant went fast asleep. Now is my time, said Jack, and picking up the harp, he ran off with it. But the harp was a magic one and called out, "Master! Master!" as Jack ran away with it. The giant awoke with a roar like thunder, thundered off him. So it was you, you villain, you who robbed me of my hen, my manny bugs, and now my harp. When I catch you, I will eat you alive. Jack ran as fast as he could till he got to the beanstalk. Down he slid, the harp still playing. Jack cried, "Stop!" And the harp stopped at once. Jack heard the giant cutting down the beanstalk after him, and calling, "Mother, mother, bring me a chopper," snapped the beanstalk in two, and the wicked giant came crashing to the ground, dead. Well done, Jack.